In this video, we're going to take a look at tables in PowerPoint. This is the template downloaded from Microsoft's website, and on the third slide here, they've already got a table for us. And I'm going to insert a new slide here, and we'll do a title and content. And if you want to create a table of your own, probably the best way to do it is do a title and slide, or title and content slide, and then click on the insert table button here, and it asks you how many columns you want and how many rows you want. And the other one, we'll do one kind of like the other one, and it had 5 rows and 3 columns, and I make that selection. And if I go back here and take a look at this, you know, the obviously this has text in it, the rows are a little bit taller, but otherwise I've got the exact same thing. So it's real easy to insert a table in PowerPoint. I'm going to delete that slide now. We're going to go back here and just play with this one a little bit. Now before I do, let's select the table, or just click in the table, and we got table tools up here, and we've got a design tab and we've got a layout tab. And before I go any further, I just want to compare this with Word. The options are almost identical with the options in Word for manipulating tables. Okay, here I've opened up Word and I've inserted an empty table here, and I get the table tools up here, design and layout, just like I do in PowerPoint. And these options over here for the, let's drag this down a little bit so we can see the group names here, and I've got table style options, I've got table styles, a little more color up here, actually that may be from last, no it's not, so let's click off of that and let's pull up Word here again. So the options aren't exactly the same, but if I, you know, if I scroll through them here, and I keep losing Word when I do that, but these are my options for Word. And if I go up here and look, and these are my options for PowerPoint. Okay, and then I've got shading, I've got stuff for borders here, which is similar. You know, here I've got a border painter, I've got stuff for pen color and the weight and the style of the lines. Not quite the same, but it's similar. Then we've got a layout tab up here, and we've also got a layout tab here. And these aren't quite the same either, but they're pretty similar. If you look at the rows and columns group here, it's almost the same as the rows and columns group here. I've got merge and split. I've got the ability to set the width and the height. Distribute rows and columns. I've got my alignment. Here they listed as 9 possibilities. Here they give 3 for horizontal and 3 for vertical, and 3 times 3 is 9, so there's 9 combinations there. I've got options for text direction, cell margins, width and height. Here I can lock the aspect ratio. So it's not exactly the same. I've got a few extra things over here. Basically it looks like these 3 properties, draw table and eraser, are different. Otherwise, you know, if I just drag this over a little bit and line it up under there, things are looking pretty much the same. So it's not identical, but if you know how to use the options in one of these applications, you pretty much know how to do them in the other. So we can close out a Word here, and no, I don't want to save that, and we can go back in and take a look at our PowerPoint table. Now let's go to the design tab, and a couple of things I want to look at. First of all, these options over here, you can turn them on or off. Header row will make the first row look different, so if you have column headings at the top, which you frequently do, it'll make them look different, so probably you want that turned on. At least in this case we do. A total row will make the bottom row look different. If you have columns of numbers and you've got some total results down there at the bottom, but that's not the case here, so we'll turn that back off. Banded rows makes it easier for your eyes to move across the row. If I turn that off, every row looks exactly the same, so we'll leave that back on as well. Sometimes you have labels in your first column that you want to look different, just like your first row. Sometimes you want your last column to look different. You might have some totals or something over there. And sometimes you want banded columns, and banded columns and banded rows at the same time are not really a good idea. It really looks funny. And most of the time you're probably going to want banded rows rather than banded columns. So we'll go back to what we had here to begin with. And then we've got a whole bunch of options here for table styles, and it does do a live preview for you. And unfortunately it covers up a lot of the table when you do that. So there is an alternative. You can go and click on the down arrow and it moves you through all of the rows up there. And I guess I'm at the bottom now. So when you have one of the rows visible, if you move the mouse over it, you can get a live preview and you can see how everything in your table is going to look. So go up another row and do my live previews here. I just have to be patient enough to pause the mouse for a second or so to let the live preview take effect. Then we got options for shading and borders and effects over here. If you want to select anything in your table, go to the top to select a column, get a fat black arrow pointing down. There's not a very big area here where it's a fat black arrow, but when you get it, you can click. And if you want to do multiple columns, you can click and drag. Same thing applies over here on the left. If you get a fat black arrow pointing to the right, you can select rows. And you can click and drag as well over here. Okay, so you can pretty much select anything you want. If you just want, you know, a cell in here, you can click on the cell. If you want several cells in here, get your arrow pointing at about 1 o'clock and click and drag, and now I've got those four cells selected. So it's pretty much works the way you'd expect it to work. So you can change the shading here easily. So let's say I want those cells to be green. I can do that. Let's do a Control Z to get rid of that. You can go in here and you can do borders around the selections that you've made. And we're not going to do that. You've got some options here for word art that do not appear on the word ribbon. Let's take a look. Oh, we got some effects here too. You can add a bevel. Now before I do that, let's make sure I select the whole table. And so you can add a bevel, which gives it kind of a 3D effect. And notice, just like everything else, they've all got names associated with them. So you can identify a specific type of bevel here by just specifying the name. You can do shadows. And we're not seeing much here for shadows. A little bit at the bottom or on the side. They're not very significant. And you can kind of make it look like it's floating here. These are a little bit easier to see. And you can do reflections. Get a little bit of reflection down there in front of the table. And you can customize that as much as you want to, but that's not really a big deal. Okay, let's go to the Layout tab here. After you've created your table, you may want to delete some things. You can delete columns, you can delete rows, you can delete the entire table. So let's say I don't want this row here anymore. I can do delete rows, and whatever rows I have selected will get deleted. Let's undo that. If you want to insert above, I've got this row selected. If I want to insert a blank row above, that's what I do. If I want to, let's undo that. If I want to insert a row below, I can do that. And if I want to insert to the left of a column, now let's select the column before we do that. And we'll undo it. And if we want to insert to the right of that column, there we go. And we'll undo that one as well. You can take cells and merge them. Now a problem with merging cells is, let's try that. You know, if you've got text in three cells already, then your text is probably going to look a little bit funny. You can split cells, and an easy way to do this would just been to do undo. But if you want to split it, I want three columns there where I was before in one row, and I click on that. And see now, it doesn't know where to break up the text here. So to get it back the way it was before, let's do a couple of undos. You can select the height of a row. I've only got one row selected there, so that's the only one that's going to be affected. If I want to select the entire table, Then I can select the height of every row in the table. And let's put 0.8 in there. There we go. You can set the width. You know, if your rows are not evenly distributed, you can get them evenly distributed between whatever the top edge is here and the bottom edge is down here. I've still got everything selected. You can change the alignment. Let's center these horizontally. And we're probably not going to see much of a change. Well, I think maybe we will. There. We can move them to the top of the cell. We can move them to the bottom of the cell. Or we can put them right smack in the middle of the cell. So now I've got it centered both horizontally and vertically. You can change text direction plus or minus 90 degrees. I don't know if there's very many times when you actually need to do that. You can mess with cell margins, which gives you a little bit more of a border around the edge here. But really, if you have the ability to select the height of each row and the width of each column, that's probably not a big deal. You can change the height of the entire table. And we're not going to worry about, maybe we can do the align one here. If I want to align it to the slide, let's align it to the middle. Let's do center first. Okay, that's an obvious change. And I've got a little bit more space up here on the top, but I probably want a little more space because that's where my title is. But we will try aligning it to the middle of the slide vertically, and that's what I get. I think I liked it down better. So those are your basic options for manipulating tables. It's pretty straightforward. And if you know how to do tables in Word, everything is almost exactly the same in PowerPoint as it is in Word.